Quick reminder, you can download your free Speed app to your phone. Keep speed at your fingertips and fuel your racing passion with Speed on your mobile phone. Get the latest results, news, photos, whatever you want, exclusive videos. Download the app from the iTunes or Android market right now. You get more Speed on your iPhone or Android personal device. We're back. It's the season opener for the AMA Pro National Guard Superbike Championship. And bike one, position one. The two-time and defending Superbike champ Josh Hayes leading the way. I said before we went to the break, he's flying the flag for Yamaha. Who was the last rider to win a Superbike race here at the World Centre of Racing aboard a Yamaha? Do I need to give you a hint? I won't embarrass you. It was you. Okay. Scott Russell, our world champion. And that was back in 1998.
It's been a while, hasn't it? It's a different racetrack now. It's faster motorcycles. Here we go. We got Chris Moore and Chris Ulrich right here battling it out. It's good to see Mitch Hansen and the KTM crew and back out here. They had the rug pulled out from under them, gave it back to them. I wasn't sure if they were going to be here this year, but they're here. Chris Fillmore is a young and up-and-comer. Saw him in the Harley class, saw him on this thing a couple of times last year, and I'm just excited to see that a new entry into the series and full-time, hopefully. Chris Ulrich in front of him also. Riding very well right here. So he's got everything dialed in and moving forward nicely.
And Greg, isn't it encouraging to see Chris Ulrich, considering the injuries that he sustained last year with that savage crash at Infineon? Isn't it good to see him back?
It certainly is, Lee. I mean, he had a wicked head injury last year. And, you know, this is the most time that he spent on a motorcycle in the last 10 months. And so he told me that he's extremely sore because he hasn't had an opportunity to ride a motorcycle very much. But every lap that he goes on, his brain is starting to work a little bit better, a little bit faster, and he's getting a little bit of time.
What a drastically different race and situation to this time a year ago. Do you know, in 2011, with both Superbike races and the Daytona 200, the margin of victory, the cumulative margin of victory for all three races was just over a tenth of a second. Josh Hayes has 7.1 seconds over Blake Young.
That's amazing. I'll tell you what. I mean, this. The changes that they'd made in the AMA to make this racing closer has definitely worked. I mean, the last 2 years, I've seen some of the best racing I've ever seen in this series. And just like you said, Lee, I mean, to have that, that's an unbelievable number right there. But it's drastically different, like you said. Here we see Ben Bostrom pick the bike up, brush himself off, and he's back out there, and he's running around right now in 13th position, going to get him a couple of points. And, hey, man, that means a lot down at the end of the year on the other end of this. So Ben did the right thing. Heron tried to do the right thing as well. Don't know what happened to him. We'll have to get back on that.
Final lap and a half, and when you say every point counts, it really does. When the margin, the championship-winning margin for Josh Hayes was 5 points over Blake Young last year. Oop, down goes the 41 of Eric Pinson. He's able to pick it up and get going again. There's a little bit of debris on the track there as well, but it was on the inside, so hopefully that's not going to affect any of the other riders. As we wind this one down, Josh Hayes is not far away from opening up the new racing season with victory. Here's what happened to Pinson.
Yeah, he looks like he overshot that right in the infield, and there's nothing he could do here. He had to kind of dump the biker who's going to run back across the track and take the other rider out. So good on you, Eric. Good job just there. But and able to still pick the bike up and only lost about 3 spots. So he's doing all he can out there on that BMW.
Never get sick of hearing that Yamaha. It's got such a distinctive note. Big throaty roar as Josh Hayes, the 36-year-old from Mississippi who resides in California. All of that off-season work from him and the Graves Yamaha team is paying off. He's going to go through NASCAR 3 and 4, through the tri-oval. He'll know that he'll have just one lap to go before he notches up his 40th AMA victory. That is something special, and he's going to draw level with you. How do you feel about that?
I feel good about it, really. I mean, if I got 40 wins, I'm happy, you know what I'm saying? And Josh, he's going to get a lot more than that as time goes on, and he's a good guy, and I'm happy to see him get this. If he pulls this thing off one more lap, he'll have it.
Blake Young, 8.4 seconds in second place. Roger Hayden maintains his third. Here is Larry Pegram and Steve Rapp, a couple of Superbike veterans and AMA veterans. This is great stuff. That's for fourth place. The BMW grabs that position.
This is awesome. This is not the Larry Pegram I saw right before the race, because he was not happy about things. Man, they figured out something, and here he goes sliding that BMW coming out of there, coming out of turn one, swoops around here. He's going to break it hard, and Steve Rapp now, he's got to go to school real quick because he ain't got but about a half a lap to figure out how I'm going to get back in front of number 72.
I think Larry rides better when he's a bit grumpier anyway.
Apparently so. Doing well right here because he was not happy, man.
The Foremost Insurance Pegram Racing BMW. Second full season for Larry and the team. And Steve Rapp's not done with yet either.
Well, let's see if Steve can kind of line him up for that move that Larry put on him. Larry drafted him as he come down this front straightaway. Steve sits right back there on his rear wheel. Let's see if that attack bike has got the motor to pull around that BMW. He's going to try around here in the infield. Nope, he's going to sit back in here. He's just trying to stay as close as he can to that number 72. Wheelies off down that back straightaway, back to the front man up front.
This is it. Here he comes. Josh Hayes, the defending series champion, gets his very first win at Daytona International Speedway. That's a milestone for Hayes, and he continues his winning ways. He has been asked for so long, what do you have to do to get your first superbike win at Daytona? Well, just what he's done there. A commanding performance from the two-time defending champ, Steve Rapp, who's won a Daytona 200. He knows what drafting's all about here. Is he going to spoil it for Pegram?
Oh, it's going to be close. Wow. Pegram looked like he got that.
Larry Pegram. Nice work. He does hold on to fourth place indeed. But let's go down where they're celebrating, Greg, at the Graves Yamaha camp.
Well, Jim, congratulations. You've dominated so far this